greatness. It's just something we made up. Somehow we've come to believe that greatness is a gift, reserved for a chosen few. For prodigies. For superstars. And the rest of us can only stand by watching. You can forget that. Greatness is not some rare DNA strand. It's not some precious thing. Greatness is no more unique to us than breathing. We're all capable of it. All of us.
To take that first step towards greatness, it's very hard. That's the hardest step of everything, is that first step, right?
Yeah.
That first step towards greatness is hard.
Yeah.
But what's a lot harder
is
when time expires in life. You look back on your life, knowing you could have been great.
Yeah.
That's something you can't control anymore because time's run out. But if you don't believe you can do it, don't even start the journey. It's too hard. It's a winnable, easy war. But if you don't believe it, then don't do it.
If you're trying to do something meaningful, if you don't have the mindset that you're the best ever, you've failed already. And that's been my mindset since I can remember. That will be my mindset as long as I can remember anything, that I am the best ever at what I do. And every day that I step on the basketball floor, I will strive to be that. But my mindset will always be as such as I am the best to do what I do.
Let me tell you something you already know. The world ain't all sunshine and rainbows. It's a very mean and nasty place, and I don't care how tough you are, it will beat you to your knees and keep you there permanently if you let it. You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done. Now, if you know what you're worth, then go out and get what you're worth. But you've got to be willing to take the hits and not pointing fingers saying you ain't where you want to be because of him or her or anybody. Cowards do that, and that ain't you. You're better than that.
I'm here to tell you, number one, that most of you say you want to be successful, but you don't want it bad. You just kind of want it. You don't want it badder than you want a party. You don't want it as much as you want to be cool. Most of you don't want success as much as you want to sleep.
It's a good separation for me, you know, emotionally, to be able to put myself in a place where at practice, when I'm training or doing games, I switch my mind to something else. I switch my mode into something else, right? For me, it's the equivalent of Maximus Decimus Meridius and Gladiator picking up the dirt. Smelling the dirt, it's go time, right? So that was my mental switch. It was like an actor getting ready for a film. You gotta put yourself in that cage. When you're in that cage, you are that character. And then when you leave there, it's something completely different. But when I'm in that cage, bro, don't fucking touch me. Don't talk to me.
There's somebody out there right now, the light ain't on you, but keep making plays. Nobody's talking about you, but keep making plays.
Right.
I know your sales numbers aren't where your friend is, but keep making plays. I know nobody's talking about you, and you're not on the leaderboard right now. Keep making plays.
Nobody's going to believe in you until you've already done it. Nobody's going to come and celebrate with you until you've already done it. All right? The work is going to come before the belief, which means you're going to have to work for a long fucking time by yourself, with no applause, with no awards, with nobody telling you good job. And then once you start to build something and people start to see the momentum and they start to see the result and you start doing some things, then you're going to get a little belief.
My number one competition is me. It's always you versus you. You got to be the one to get up every morning, be disciplined, put in the consistent daily hard work, because that gains success. No coach, no trainer, no mentor, no boss can do it. You versus you.
Be the guy who embraces the ugly, the miserable. Be the guy who embraces hard work, the grind. Don't be afraid of being hurt. Don't be afraid of sacrificing some blood.
Fear is an illusion. We have to have desire. We have to have something that pushes us. Fear pushes us.
When you invest in something and you hustle and you work for something, you got a different type of attachment to it. You're going to have a cold day in hell for somebody to try to take this from you. We live by this. We die by this. We don't surrender. We don't retreat. Every man must search his own soul. I listen to that quote every morning.
The man who loves walking will walk further than the man who loves the destination. And when you love the journey, the goals just happen. You hit milestones as a side effect because it doesn't matter. At that point, I don't care if I can lift this much weight or run this fast. I mean, that's cool, but I don't love it as much as I love the journey. I love the journey. What does the journey consist of? Sucking at something, failing, getting better, learning, start it over, do it again. When you fall in love with the journey, everything else takes care of itself.
Perspective drives performance every day of the week. How we view what we do will always affect and impact how we do what we do. How we do anything is how we do everything, right? Yes, sir. For most of us, we change our dedication, our commitment, how we show up, our sacrifice, depending upon situation, circumstance, external factor, and sometimes people, right? Which I feel is extremely dangerous.
It's all on you. It's all on you. The self part is what's big. I'm gonna make myself good enough. I'm driven. I'm obsessed. I want to prove people wrong. I'm a warrior. A warrior is a motherfucker who says, hey, I'm here again today. I'm here again tomorrow. I'm going to be here the next day. It's a person that puts no fucking limit on what's possible. If you want to be great, you want to be the baddest motherfucker ever at what you do, you're going to be misunderstood by everybody because you're going to be so fucking obsessed and so driven to get there. That's what it takes. It takes every second of your fucking life. Anybody says balance? Yeah, balance is important for a lot of fucking people. It is. But if you want to fucking go to that edge where people do not like you, don't understand you, question everything you fucking do, you've arrived. When people don't understand you anymore, you're in that spot of obsession and drive.
If you really want this, you got to learn to sacrifice. You got to learn to give up to go up.
While he was golfing, I was studying. You can't get out of something that you're not willing to put into it. You have to put your everything, your mind, your energy, your effort, your discipline. Nothing is going to jump out the fire. If you don't throw something in there, it's not going to happen.
But if you dare to be great, if you dare to go to limits that you've never went to before, they will remember your legacy forever. I'm obsessed with improvement. Every day I'm getting better. There are those of you with phones, and every new phone that comes out, you get it. You are upgrading your technology, and you've not upgraded yourself. So listen to me. There are those of you who said, I want to be a millionaire. I want to be the best at this company, right? But your value system says you believe in sleep more than you believe in grinding.
Motivation is crap. It's shit. People right now, maybe listen to this shit, they'll be motivated to go run. If it's cold somewhere where they're at, a lot of my friends will shut that door, go back inside. That's motivation. It comes and goes as how you feel. If you and your wife are good, if you and your kids are good, if you're good at work, you're motivated. I like a motherfucker whose life is imploded, ain't got shit in life, and says, still got to fucking get after today, man.
And a lot of times you have to learn to perform without motivation. You have to learn to perform without purpose. You have to learn to perform a lot of different things. And that's what people think. They think I need to have this motivation to work out, to study, to be better.